Margaret?
My name is Margaret Ewing, and I'm from Atlanta, Georgia, and I'm 26. I brought my wedding planner with me today, my cousin Ashley, my aunt Sherry, and I also brought my friend Phoebe.
You guys look so nice.
I've been really indecisive about what I wanted because my mom's not here. My mom had gone to ride her bike about 3 years ago, and she just didn't come home for dinner. We found out that they had found her body and that she had been murdered. Sorry. When we found out she was gone, it was just hard to believe. It's been a really tough few years for me and for my family.
But Margaret's life brightened a few years later when she met her fiancé.
My fiancé's name is William Gaither. He's just a really kind, loving person. He's just a really great guy. Without my mom there, Will has been really involved in my wedding plans. I've obviously dreamed about this day my whole life. It's a little bittersweet for me. I wish my mom could be there, but it's also the happiest day of my life. This is really hard to pick out a wedding dress without her.
So hard, in fact, that Margaret is already afraid she made a mistake.
I should probably tell you, I already bought a dress.
You already got a dress?
I already ordered a dress from here, and I'm just not excited about that dress. And I never really was. I never could find one that I really, really wanted. My indecisiveness is just from my mom not being here. So I didn't know if I found another one today, if I could, like, exchange it.
I really can't allow people that have purchased a dress here to exchange them. We place the order with the designer. It immediately goes into cutting, and they don't let us exchange them.
Okay, well, I may have to stay with that one, or if I find one I really love, then I'll try to work it out.
Okay. I'm not sure what we're gonna do, but I know we need to find a gown to make this girl smile again.
We're gonna put Margaret back in the dress that she purchased, just so I can see what she doesn't like about it, to help me move forward and see if she wants to go in another direction.
Fresh dress. That is
pretty. So this is the one that I already bought and ordered.
Okay.
Like, I want it to be more fitted through here, so they like pull it in. The waist is too long or something through here. It had that big flower on the back, and I felt like that was really, really creative. But the rest of the dress I didn't really like.
And Margaret's not the only one unhappy with her old dress.
I was thinking she wanted something more form.
Right.
Yeah. I wish that she'd have maybe like
a little
bling. Just a little bit, nothing that's like crazy or anything like that.
It just didn't
grab us, maybe.
That was it.
Yeah.
It's just not what I'm looking for.
I really hope I can find Margaret a dress today.
Let's go and find another one.
Okay.
Margaret is looking for a dress that's a little bit more fitted, a little bit more flirty and fun.
It is very light.
Very outdoorsy, very whimsical.
Another one.
Ooh, that's pretty too.
Oh, wow.
Okay,
what do you think?
Difficult.
I don't like how the sparkles like light up,
yeah,
like Christmas lights or something.
They
like, the sparkliness of it is just too on and off. It was too flashy.
Next up, Flo tries a more glamorous look.
Wow.
That's different.
That's beautiful. You like it?
No, I don't. It's too heavy and I don't think it's good for outside.
Right.
Too much of a ball gown for getting married in the gardens. It's just too dressy or something.
You're right.
I know.
Dressy.
I'm not sure that Margaret is into choosing a dress without her mom here. And I'm not sure that we're gonna find her a dress.
2 hours and 8 dresses, and nothing that Bride Margaret has tried has stuck.
I like the top, but I don't like the bottom.
She doesn't seem quite into it, and it really makes me sad.
I'm pretty discouraged about it. Either they're too vintage or too plain.
We're not gonna give up until we find Margaret a dress that knocks her socks off.
Lori has every one of us in this bridal salon looking high and low to find this girl a dress.
Monty has a plan.
All right. And we can take the flower off too if you don't like it.
Okay.
Robin has a bride that had a dress on, and I think it may be perfect for Margaret.
Oh, wow. I think that's pretty. It is.
I love it.
I really like this one.
I can tell because your face lit up.
Oh my gosh.
This is the best reaction we've gotten.
That's
all right. The more I looked down in the mirror, I am realizing it's perfect. I like this one better. I'm like, I'm sorry. I thought my mom would love it. I do.
Margaret. Oh, she's crying. She loves it.
Daughters, all they want is their mom's approval. I mean, in 30 years, I've seen it over and over and over again.
It's special. It's very special.
She just wanted her mom.
You feel like a bride in this one.
I do.
And that's important. That's how we wanted you to feel today.
Margaret is finally ready to walk down the aisle in this dress. But there's just one problem.
She really wants to return the other one.
I already bought a dress. I don't know that I can afford both of them.
All of a sudden, I'm sort of like, oh, she already bought a dress. What am I going to do? I really can't allow brides to return the gowns if they have buyer's remorse.
I'm worried that it's not going to work out.
After all she's been through, I really don't know what I'm going to do.
This is Lori. Lori,
hey, I'm Margaret. So you already ordered another one?
I did.
Okay.
And I've tried it back on, and I don't like it at all now.
Okay.
When she came out, her face looked very tense, and so I was a little nervous.
Well, I normally never do this. But that's going to be my gift to you.
Oh!
That's my wedding
gift. Yes, thank you.
Actually, it's all of our
wedding gifts. Oh, thank you so much. I'm trying not to cry.
We all knew her story. The last thing I wanted her to be thinking of on the wedding day was that she hated the dress she was wearing.
Well, we want you to have a special day.
Thank you so much.
You're
this
welcome.
Really does make it special.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Oh, I'm so worried about that because I didn't think they'd be able to do that. I just feel like my mom really, really would like that. I just felt really excited to feel that way. It made it a lot more special for me just to have all these people here willing to make that happen. It just is really amazing, and I'm just so thankful.
I wanted Margaret Ewing to walk down that aisle and say, I look like a million bucks.
Oh, I love it.
In Alterations, a bride arrives whose mother has helped her through a recent rough patch.
Hey, nice to meet you too. This is my mother, June.
Hi.
I brought my mom. I mean, she's my rock and my support, and I can't make decisions without her.
Emily needed all the support she could get when her first dress fitting went terribly wrong.
I tried on the dress. I had it on for less than 10 minutes, and when they took it off of me, I crumbled to the ground because my back couldn't support the weight of it. I dealt with some severe back pain for the last 8 years, and I re-injured my back and realized that the discs had ruptured, and I wasn't able to stand or walk or anything. I had to have surgery less than 4 months before the wedding.
So are you ready to put it on?
I am. This is the first time that I've been able to see it since my back surgery, and so I'm worried about the weight of the dress. Am I going to be able to support it?
I'm hoping that she doesn't hurt and the pain doesn't come through.
I just hope it's not going to be too heavy. I'm scared.
Okay. Saw her eyes, and I could tell that she was not hurting.
Do you like it?
Then I looked more at the dress, and it was wonderful.
My dress felt better than I thought it was going to, and it is more beautiful than I remembered it being. I wish the wedding were tomorrow now.
But while Emily can comfortably wear the gown for a few minutes, will her back have the strength to support it for her entire wedding day in 3 weeks?
I'll have the dress on at least 6 hours, and I've been very nervous about that.
And in downtown Atlanta, it's Emily's wedding day.
I'm completely overwhelmed. My back feels good. It's been a long process getting to this day, but I feel better than I felt in years, and I know that had I not had the surgery, I wouldn't have been able to handle today.
And when she meets her fiancé, Craig, at the altar, she knows they've truly put the pain and struggle of her surgery at their backs.